Hello, I'm Ultimate Reviews of Ultimate Animation, and boy, 2023 was an awesome year for animation, with groundbreaking movies and series left, right, and center, any of which could make a great and relevant topic for a video. But I want to talk about the Ninja Turtles. But to be fair, the TMNT are kind of always relevant, existing in some form or another since their introduction in 1984. I mean, with a title and premise as bizarre as Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, and these distinct characters that are easy to latch onto, how could it not be one of the most interesting and long-lasting franchises out there? There are so many movies and series and animated series and games and comics, and I've been an avid consumer of any and all things TMNT related, from the great to the not so great. But the cool thing is, each one takes the basic concept and can take it in any direction, creating something that still represents the interesting initial idea, but has a totally unique spin. I could talk for ages about the Turtles themselves and their many incarnations, and I will soon, but that's its own video. Today I wanted to talk about the most recent Turtles content, the upcoming Paramount animated film, TMNT Mutant Mayhem. The trailer, to be specific. Now, whenever a new great series of anything ends, especially if it develops a strong fanbase and then is cut short unfairly, there's a tendency for that fanbase to be hesitant, to say the least, on new versions because it's too drastically different. And the brain tends to dislike change, especially if it's perceived as replacing the previous version of said beloved thing, regardless of how inaccurate that perception is. Now, since the internet is a place of exaggeration and extremes, this problem is exacerbated in online fan circles, ranging from just the standard, "What is this? Why is this different?" reaction, to the more explicitly hostile, immediately declaring current thing to be garbage before it's even released. Sometimes new thing is legitimately garbage, but not always. When that goes to the level of attacking creators or even fans who like the new thing just for liking it, That's really not okay. Reevaluate your priorities, my guy. But mobs are gonna mob, regardless of how many times you tell them it's not that deep. I doubt I'm going to change that. The real reason I bring this up is because while I don't ever think I took it too far as some people, I have caught myself falling into this trap, specifically with TMNT. When Rise was announced so shortly after the cancellation of the 2012 series and seemed so drastically different, I too was less than open to it. And after seeing the first episode, I left it alone for a bit. You'd think I would have learned by now that judging a show off its first episode is a terrible idea. Well, eventually I did, and coming back to it and putting aside my preconceptions, I had a blast. It's funny, it's action-packed, the story is balanced well with the humor. Rise is easily some of the best content of any TMNT adaptation. I was wrong. So when that too was cut short, with season 3 being cancelled entirely and season 2 being cut in half, because Nickelodeon doesn't know how to be an animation network to save their lives, I also got pretty peeved and was less than thrilled that a new movie that once again looked drastically different was announced so soon after. It felt like Rise wasn't given the proper chance to shine. But I didn't want to make the same mistake twice. I want to learn from my past errors. Transgressions. So I went into the trailer with an open mind, not comparing it to previous versions so much as letting it be its own interpretation and seeing if it looks like it'll stand as its own thing. And that's what this video is, an open-minded but honest reaction to Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Mutant Mayhem trailer, because good TMNT content can only be a good thing. Spoilers if you've not watched the trailer yet.
Right off the bat, this movie has a huge advantage, being directed by the writer and co-director of Mitchells vs. the Machines. And like Mitchells and several projects that have been released since Spider-Verse showed mainstream animation companies, hey, stylized animation is actually awesome, this film is taking advantage of the fact that it's animated, being another 2D and 3D hybrid film that invokes the look of the comics. Kind of gritty like the comic, but with the humor and speed of Mitchells. Either way, it's a huge plus, and after years of most animated films looking so samey and bland for so long, I'm so glad this is the style that is becoming the new trend, and that it's being used in so many different creative ways.
Here I really like these establishing shots of the city followed by the turtles bursting onto the scene. It's a good way to show off both the environment well, but also the movement of the characters all in one go. We then see all four of the brothers at once, clearly messing around with their weapons and recording it. A couple of things to note here. One is the voices. The turtles look and sound a lot younger than most previous versions, clearly playing into the teenage aspect of them, which is an important aspect I think a lot of versions skip over. and I give credit that these voice actors chosen are actually teenagers and not unexperienced, but also not super big names either. It feels like they were chosen because of their voices, not because they're big names. It's got plenty of other celebrity voices for that. But seriously, I like this younger, less experienced look at the Turtles. I'm guessing the movie will focus heavily on their journey learning how to be crime fighters and the rise, pun intended, of their status as destined heroes. This shot also does a good job of quickly establishing their general personalities and their dynamics as a group, which isn't easy to do in such a short time frame, but they pull it off. I can already tell these voice actors are going to work well off each other. Even with just a brief few seconds, you already feel this kind of camaraderie and sibling dynamic. We also get a brief glimpse of Splinter as well as the younger version of the Turtles. Guessing this will either be a flashback showing their training, or alternatively, will be at the start of the movie showcasing their origins before a flash forward to them at their current ages. Although they reiterate the origin later in the trailer, so maybe not a full-on flashback, not sure. A crucial element I'm holding out hope for, the brothers all seem to be getting an equal share of screen time and focus. So many versions previously have been pretty exclusively the Leo and Raph show, with their relationship being the only one focused on while Donnie and Mikey are stuck in support. This luckily doesn't seem to be going that route. As for the designs of the Turtles themselves, I like them. It is a big departure seeing them actually look young, but it works because again it seems to be focused more on the teenage part. They actually remind me a bit of Mutants in Manhattan, the TMNT video game, but with very rounded faces like the ones in the 2012 series. It's a little weird at first, but it looks like it will be easy to get used to these designs pretty quickly. The Turtles are very expressive and they move great within their environment. Again, the 2D 3D hybrid style looks really good. Not sure how to feel about Donnie with glasses, but it doesn't look bad. Now for a few other characters and Easter eggs in the trailer. Bebop and Rocksteady, who look amazing in this style. I love their designs. I hope they're in more than just one or two scenes and have good voices to match, because these designs already give off a lot of personality. I just hope it's better than the last time Seth Rogen played a warthog. Not sure who's voicing Rocksteady. I checked the cast, but I can't see him. I love this Laird joke. That was a cute nod. I also hope they continue with these Mitchell-style pop-up jokes throughout the film, because that stuff always gets a laugh out of me. And apparently there's been some discourse over April's design. Controversy aside, allow me to ignore it and say, I like it. I really like her design. She seems to be around the same age as the Turtles, which helps her fit in more with them. And I'm glad incarnations are starting to make April more the same age as the Turtles in each version. April's had a lot of incarnations over the years, which can look pretty drastically different. Some work, some don't. And this design stands out, to me at least, for really working. She looks cool to me. We'll have to wait and see if her personality is good to match. Grabby pitchforks on the way out. Putting that can of worms to one side, overall I'm pretty hyped for this. Obviously, I'm still not quite ready to leave Rise, but August is a fair bit away, so hopefully it will be enough time to adjust. But barring that personal hang-up, it looks really promising. No overt references to Shredder or Krang just yet, but there's still time. The casting is decent and, if nothing else, the animation looks great, and I'm very pleased that this is the direction Western animation seems to be headed in. I've wanted for so long for stylized animation to be recognized by the mainstream, and it's definitely getting its due right now. Let's hope stop motion isn't disappearing off the planet yet. Oh, thank God. Maybe that will be the next big thing. Stop motion and 2D and 3D in one glorious combination. Unlikely, but I can dream, can't I? More reviews and other animation-related videos coming soon, hopefully. This was just a quick something I thought was interesting to talk about. I haven't done a trailer reaction or breakdown thing for a while, so I thought I'd give it another go. Let me know if you want more of these types of videos alongside my usual reviews. In the meantime, go watch Rise, I guess. I don't know how to end this. Peace.